how do you motivate millennials and Generation Z workers in your work team? I'm Greg Schenkel, president of Unique Training and Development and Frontline Leadership Systems, and today I'm going to deal with one of the most requested topics from supervisors, managers, and team leaders. It's how to motivate the younger people in their work group. A lot of managers and supervisors tell me that it's really tough to get people to do especially difficult tasks and to stop playing with their phones and pay attention to their work tasks on the job. So the issue is, are we going to write off a whole generation of workers simply because they're accelerating a trend that even affected you and your generation compared to the ones that came before? Well, like most things, the reality is, as leaders, is we need to adapt in order to be more effective. So I'm going to share with you a few tips on how to get these younger workers to be a bit more motivated and engaged to deliver the work task that you need to get done in order to hit your numbers. Tip number one is to take time to explain why something's important. Now, explaining why is one of those core subjects that we have in our frontline leadership program, but with younger workers, it's even more important. People who are more mature and seasoned, not older necessarily, but they tend to just do things because that's the job that's been laid out for them. But younger folks want to be explained why. It's all part of the change in parenting that happened about 20 years ago, and that's what's happening in the workplace too. Younger workers want to know what the reason is that they have to do certain things or do them in a certain way. Second tip is to be more positive and encouraging in general. Being a crusty curmudgeon with a younger worker is not going to work well in most cases. They need someone who's going to be more supportive of them. Remember, parenting has changed to become more encouraging and more positive, and so do the workplaces have to be as well. That doesn't mean that you can't provide feedback, but you have to do it in a very timely way, and you have to deliver it in such a way that the millennial or Generation Z worker will accept it, process it, and then try to meet your expectations. The last tip is to involve and include these younger workers in your decision making. I know some of you feel like, hey, you got to earn your stripes before you can give some input on changes in the workplace. But the reality is, younger folks are used to at home being able to say where they want to go out for dinner or what to do on family vacations, so they expect to have the same thing happen at work. They want to be consulted, and they want to be consulted on their third day of work and their third week of work, not wait till their third year of work to be asked for their opinions. So make sure to involve and include them in most of the plans that you have in the business. Now, all that being said, as a leader, it's really important for you to work on both your mindset and your skill set. Because if you're thinking in the back of your mind that younger workers are lazy and just aren't willing to work hard and do a good job, it's going to affect your capability to lead them productively and positively. So work on that mindset, because there's lots of young folks who still want to work hard. In fact, many millennials and Gen Z, they don't like the label that we give them, that they're lazy. And remember that your parents and grandparents may have even thought that you were lazy compared to their work ethic and work conditions. So let's adapt, because we want to become employers of choice, and that means learning how to motivate and engage younger workers at the same time as we work with a multi-generation workforce. Now, once you've worked on how to motivate the younger workers that are in your team, you're going to want to work on some of your other leadership aspects. And of course, you can do that by connecting with us on our website at uniquedevelopment.com or connecting through one of the many social media channels that we're active on. No matter what, I look forward to partnering with you on your leadership journey.